When most of us think of a science lab, we think of test tubes, chemicals, and lab coats. This is called a wet lab, but wet labs and white coats aren't for everyone.
Tim Sweeney, I'm a postdoctoral research. We're at Stanford University. I grew up in Boulder, Colorado. My dad was a lawyer. My mom worked in education. Mostly like to be up in the mountains, you know, rock climbing and mountaineering and that sort of thing. I like to build stuff. I did, you know, set construction and lighting design and stuff like that in the theater. Played baseball for a while and was pretty bad at it, so I stopped. I had always liked science. I wasn't like a standout student until sort of pretty late in high school, really. I actually, even through college, planned on just getting a PhD and doing, I wanted to do neuroscience research. And it was while I was in college that I met one of the professors of neuroscience there who suggested I get an MD. In addition to the PhD, maybe I'd be good at seeing patients. So that's why I decided to go to med school, and I did the joint MD-PhD degree together. Our lab focuses on integrating public data in gene expression.
So you have these processes being called up. So you actually have an instance of R Studio running like four separate R processes. Who knows?
All of the cells in the body have DNA, of course, and the DNA codes for proteins, and the message that codes for those proteins comes out in RNA. And there is a technology now that can basically measure all of the sort of expression levels of these RNAs in the body all at once. And so step one is sort of combing through the data to find these genes. Step two is then turning that from an interesting scientific finding into a relevant clinical test, and that takes a lot more prospective validation, which is sort of, you know, testing it again in a new set of patients, and also the partnering with, you know, engineers and people that know how to actually build something that you know, a doctor can use.
How would you describe the culture in the lab?
Pretty laid back.
Like, it'll have this kind of pattern, but mm-hmm. these two are the ones they should be focusing on.
But they're focusing on the other two.
On the other two, yeah.
And they're getting things right?
I don't know. We don't have them yet. Maybe they are getting right.
Certainly, I found Stanford to be a very relaxed place. People work at their own pace, and it's pretty collaborative. Someone's working on something in the lab, they're always happy to share with others. Compared to being a surgery resident where you're working 80 hours a week and there's constant emergencies, you know, sitting at a desk and running some math and writing some programs maybe doesn't feel quite as tense as that. It's not easy either. You know, if you're not working on something that's relevant, then sometimes you feel like you're falling behind a little bit. So I think it's more just that you are at your own pace. You know, it's up to you. No one's going to tell you to work faster. You just sort of don't get ahead. You don't get things done. Both are part art and both are part science. You know, one of the key things about knowing how to practice medicine is that it informs more likely hypotheses. You know, you've come up with some question and maybe you might be more right because you've studied sort of how the body works. But I think more importantly, it informs asking good questions. What you want to do is work on something that affects a lot of people, or affects a small number of people in a big way, or affects a lot of people in a big way, and can make an advance that can actually help them. The science especially has a lot of ups and downs. You know, the thrill of discovery, and then the downside of discovering that your discovery doesn't hold up in something else. You have to have some sort of internal momentum that keeps you going and lets you know that this is still the right path, even if it feels like it's not at times. But that does require sort of a willingness to stick with the program, even if it's going to be 5 or 10 more years or something like that. You know, there's a little bit of maybe, you know, innate intelligence, but mostly it's training. You know, it's people being willing to do the hard work, to learn the skills, to do the research. You don't have to know right now where you want to be in 10 years. You just have to point your ship somewhere and start sailing. And if you find something that's even better along the way, then great, track that down. The more sort of time you spend learning these skills and techniques and training, I mean, it doesn't maybe sound like a ton of fun, but it opens a lot of doors, and you never know where you'll end up.